Hello students, are you all right? I hope so. You all are all right and you are watching your favorite channel PPY tutorial and you are enjoying a lot, I think. And we have already learned up to the series and parallel combination of resistance after Ohm's law. And I think you all have idea about those two topics. We are going to use those idea in today's class. And today we are going to learn very, very powerful tools which is going to help you to solve the numerical problem at very fast speed, and that will be very interesting. And if you know this topic, then numerical problems of DC circuit will not be difficult for you ever. And so pay attention and bring your copy and pen so that you can do along with me. I have already told you, you don't think that you are just watching YouTube video. You are learning, and you are learning. You are good students, and you are paying proper attention. And so, let's start. Today's topic is voltage divider. Voltage divider. This is today's topic, and this is very powerful tool for the numerical problem. And so what does this tell? Suppose there are two resistance, this resistance, one is R1 and other is R2. And I have connected these to one DC source, that is battery and series. Suppose by total voltage of battery, terminal potential difference we call, that voltage is V. And how much voltage develop across R1, I can tell this as a V1 up to L. And V2 is developed across the resistance R2. Now, shortcut trick, what can we say? V1 is simply, V1 is resistance across which this V1 is developed, that is R1 upon total resistance in series, R1 plus R2, R1 plus R2 times total volt applied across this resistance, that is V. And instantly you can find the voltage, how much voltage, without finding the current in this case. While solving the numerical problem, it will be very helpful to you. Okay, next V2, tell me what will be then. Next, I am going to find the voltage across R2. So I have to take resistance R2 in numerator and total resistance in series, that is R1 and R2. So this is R1 plus R2. Next is total voltage. So this is the total voltage V. So very easily you can find the voltage if resistance is here. For example, I am taking this as the 2 ohm resistance and this is the 6 ohm resistance, and this I take the voltage 12 volt. So what will be the voltage across R1? Very easily you can tell. This is the 2, and 2 plus 6 is 8. Times total voltage is 12. So we can cut 4 to the 4, 3 that 2 to cut here, and you will get 3 volt. Likewise, if you have to find across the R2, then there is 6. So 6 upon total is 2 plus 6, that is again 8, times total voltage is 12, and again same thing, 2 the 3 the, and this. So we will get 9 volts. Check it. 3 plus 9 is 12. Total is 12 voltage is still there. So this powerful tool is going to help you. Keep in the mind and know the technique. Likewise, if we would have 3 resistance. Suppose this is R1, this is R2 and this is R3. Then we have another voltage source. Suppose I give it this time. Okay, let me write the V, and this resistance is R1, this is R2, this is R3, and voltage across this is V1, and voltage across second one is V2, and voltage across third is, if you take V3, then what will you get? V1 is directly, you can write V1 equals to, V1 is resistance across which V1 is developed is R1, that is R1 by total is R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is R1 plus R2 plus R3, and total voltage is Rv, and so I can add this V. Likewise, you can tell me what is V2? First, I am waiting for you. Go to answer. That's
R2 by R1 plus R2 plus R3
times voltage V. Likewise, V3 will equals to
R3 by R1 plus R2 plus R3 times voltage.
So, is this very easy topic?
Yeah.
Yes, this is very easy but very powerful use. I'll show you when I'll teach you numerical problem. I'll write most of the problems we can solve using this voltage divider rule because it saves our times. What time it saves? We have to first find the current, then we have to find overall resistance, then we have to find voltage across each resistor. So two steps we can jump. So while attempting the entrance examination, there is the you need not to show the process, just you need to get the answer. At that time you can use this trick. Okay, now a question comes in your mind. How this formula comes? Let me derive this. And for this I have to draw. Okay, and so for the derivation I do not take any data. Okay, let me clear this board. Okay, and so suppose this battery is giving total current I. And what will be the total resistance? Equivalent resistance R equals to, they are in series, so you know in series they are just simple sum. Next I have to find the current, and so current equals to total voltage, here is the V, and total resistance now became this R. So I got V upon R1 plus R2. Okay, and then I have to get the voltage across first resistor. So using Ohm's law, I can write V1 equals to I times R1. So I is your V upon R1 plus R2 times R1. Rearrange this term. And so if you rearrange R1 by R1 plus R2, you can write R1 plus R2 times total voltage V. That was our V1 which I told you the trick. Okay. Likewise, and you want to get V2. So V2 will be same style, you can write I into R2, and you know I is your V by R1 plus R2 times your R2. Again you rearrange, you write R2 in the beginning, and so R2 by R1 plus R2 times total voltage. See, it was quite easy to derive also. Okay, and so you are going to add a note also. So let me write, let R1 and R2 be two resistors connected in series with DC source of terminal potential difference D as shown in circuit diagram. You will write this. Okay, circuit diagram. Then the equivalent resistance R is given by, you write this. So the total current I is given by, you can write this. Then now using Ohm's law, you write this, and so this is up to here. You have to write the in the voltage divider. Okay, and so you can pause if you can't write along with me then, and copy it, and again you'll do some more example of this. Okay, now it's your turn. Okay, and so example I just told in the beginning, if you want to write, then you can again copy. I told this 1 ohm resistance, this is 2 ohm resistance, this is 3 ohm resistance. And here is the nth resistor. And if you want to derive for 3, then also same technique, here will be R1 plus R2 plus R3, everything will depend. R plus R3, and you can go on doing if you want to, then what is not necessary. Okay, and so V1, here is V2, and here is V3. Now tell me what is the value of V1, V2 and V3. You can do, but I have not given you the bad source voltage, and said, suppose this is 24 volt. So we'll tell first. Can you? Are you trying? Oh, you can do it. Do fast. Here. R1 is?
4.
R1 is 1 ohm.
1.
R2 is? 2 ohm. And R3 is 3 ohm. And so you can find the voltage using, now we can write simply using voltage divider rule. Using voltage divider rule directly you can write. You think that if you write like this, your teacher will cut marks or not? No, they know this technique very well, and so they will not cut your mark. You can directly write. So V1 is R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R3 times voltage, and so you know this 1 upon total is 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. So 6 and total voltage is 24. And you know this, you can cut this 6 for that, so your answer will be 4 volt. So V1 is how much value you got?
4 volt.
Okay, are you trying or not? Try. Okay, and also we have to find V2, and so V2 will be equals to, again you can tell, this is the 2. Upon total is again 6, total voltage is 24, so 6 for the and 4 to the 8 volt. And lastly we have to find the V3, and so V3 will be equals to
12 volt.
V3 again you can tell 3 upon 6 plus, sorry, 6 times 24, 6 for the, so 4 to the 12 volt. Like this, you can use your tool voltage divider to get the voltage if resistances are in series. If resistance are not in series, then we cannot use this formula. So, to know formula is not important. When to use, how to use the formula is very important. Whenever you find the situation that resistances are in series and you have to find the voltage across any of the component, then you can use the same technique. We will do more questions, but before doing that, let's learn one more technique tool, that is a current divider. Okay, and so again you can copy that example, and I want to tell that if you know the value of V1 and V2, then third you can directly subtract from this. That's right. You got this, is the voltage here is, how much you got? 4 volt. Here you got the?
8 volt.
8 volt. And 8 plus 4 is 12. Total is 24. 24 minus 12 is 12. Directly without using this formula, I will show you could find the voltage across third resistor. Even you know that again another shortcut trick is you know that voltage across resistor directly to resistance. So I can tell voltage across 1 ohm is, I can tell that this is 1k, 1k, another 2k, and third is 3k are the voltage. Voltage across 8 cross R1, R2 and R3. Then we can tell that it's 1k, 1k plus 2k plus 3k equals to 24, so 6k equals to 24, k equals to 6 for the 24, 4, and therefore now you can tell the V1 equals to 1k, and so 1k is 4 volt, and V2 equals to, that's the 2k means 4 to the 8 volt, and V3 equals to 3k, and so 4 into 3, that's a 12 volt. So even using simple mathematics, also you can use, even you don't have the knowledge of current and voltage, then also we can. Using simple, if you know that these two quantities are directly proportional, then you can use this trick also. Okay, and so now let's move to the current divider. And so you know that current divides in the parallel, current do not divide in the series. In series, current remains the constant. So current division cannot be used in the series combination. We must have the parallel combination. For example, and so our topic is current divider rule. In book they are not giving more emphasis about this, but I thought it's very important for you, it's going to help you, so I am writing this topic. Okay, and so suppose here is one resistance This is R1 and here another resistance. There is the R2. And we want to divide the current. Suppose current from here is going. Suppose this current is I. So what will be current in the upper branch? That's I1, I am supposing, and I2 in the second branch. So here also my trick is if you want to find I1, this time you are not going to use same resistance through which I1 is going. Next to that means this is the next resistance is R2. So this time you will use the trick R2 by R1 plus R2 times total current. Okay, and so this times you got this. Likewise, what can you get for the I2? Tell me, it's your turn now. I have already told this.
R1 by R1 plus
yes,
R2.
Yes, opposite to that. Means your next branch resistance you have read. Exactly, you are correct. Okay, next resistance, that is R1 divided by total again in series. The R1, sorry, in parallel R1 plus R2 times total current. So this trick is going to help you when you know the main current and you have to divide in different branch. And you can do this very fast after doing some practice. Let's practice. Suppose I am giving you the current 6 ampere here. Suppose 6 ampere current entering through this parallel branch. So if resistance I give you there is a 5 ohm and this is the 10 ohm. Tell me what will be the value of I1. Who can tell fast? Yes, come on. You can. I1 will be equals to, tell, I am waiting for you, otherwise I could already find it. That's the 5 ohm. I have to find I1, so I cannot take 5. I told you we have to take another, that's the 10. Do not remember the formula, learn the trick. 10 means opposite branch and 10 plus 5 is 15 times total current is 6. You know this table of 5, 5 to the end, 5 3 the and 3 to the. So tell me what we'll get? 4 ampere current. Means out of 6 ampere current, 4 ampere is going through the branch R1. So remaining is 2 ampere you can directly find. So if you get only one, then other than so easy, because total current, this point cannot accumulate the current. So incoming current must be equal to outgoing current. So if this, that's called Kirchhoff's current law, we learn in next topic. And so next chapter, 6 ampere is coming and 4 ampere going through upper branch, then remaining 2 ampere goes through the lower branch. So but here we are practicing the current divider. So let's apply the same technique. I want to find current through the R2. So I have to take the resistance R1, that is 5, by total is 5 plus 10, that's again 15, into total 6. So this time 5 3 that and 3 2 that. So I told you it will be 2 ampere and we got the same thing, 2 ampere current going through this. So students, are you getting this?
Yes.
If you have any problem, then you can tell me, you can comment, or you can discuss with us on the chat. Okay, and so again we have to, if you want to derive this relation, then I don't require these values, and so for the timing I am going to omit these values. Okay, and so this was two trick I told you. Okay, again I am going to derive this formula is working or not. Okay, and so this is the one source, that's the a voltage V, okay, total current I suppose I. So let R1 and R2 be the two resistor connected in parallel with DC source of terminal potential difference V, so that total current I pass through resistors R1 and R2. So this times we have equivalent resistance to resistance, R equivalent equals to, this time you are seeing these two are in parallel, so I told you the trick, if resistance are in parallel and only two, then you can simply use the trick, product wise out. Don't think that 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 you are going to do and that will take some time. So use the technique whatever you learn in my class. The technique is, if there are two resistances that are in parallel, then simply we do product by sum. So product is R1, R2 and sum is R1 plus R2. Now we can get the total current. So total current I equals to V upon R. So now go on dividing this, and so this V equals to, V is V and R I am writing R2 times R1 plus R2. Okay, and so here what I got, this is the total current I got. Now I need to find the current I1. So again I can use the Ohm's law. And so you know that total voltage, how much voltage you are applying. This voltage are same for R2 and R1. I told you that the voltage remains same in the parallel combination. So if I have to find the current I1 will be equals to total voltage is V, and that voltage across R1 also, so V by R1. So from here if I put the value of A, V equals to what I get, R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 times I. So I am going to use this value here. So let me write. If I use that value, then what I get? V equals to R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 times here is R1. And there is current I. So see this. If I cut R1, R2 up and down, then what I get? I1 equals to, therefore you are getting current I1 equals to R2 by R1 plus R2 times total current, which I told you say. So many works. If you directly this formula, then these all works, where you look at the problem, will be saved and you will never confuse. So see this, directly I got I1 equal to R2 by R1 plus R2 times I, and also you want to get for I2. And I2 equals to same trick, V by R2, and so you are going to put the value of V, that is R1, R2 by R1 plus R2 times I, and so I, and there was my R2, and so I cut this R2 here, so again I get R1 by R1 plus R2 times total current. So this was very interesting and amazing tools for you. If you want to find the current in any of the branch, directly you see the resistance of the other branch, divide by total length series, when it will be series, and then times total current. You may think that this was not very difficult. If voltage is given directly, I can get, why should you use this formula? But it's not, the situation is not always like this simple. There may be some resistance here, and every other branch also. At that times it is going to simplify your work. Okay, and so again you want to copy, then you can pause your video and you can copy it down. This is your note, and this note you are going to revise all the time. Not just watching YouTube video and passing your time. For examination you have to revise, at that times you need this. Okay, and if you want to get this example for this, as I told you, suppose there is a this circuit, same circuit I make to make you concept clear. To make concept clear, we need a simple circuit. I told you 6 ampere current. This is a, this time I am taking the 2 ohm, and this I am taking the 3 ohm. Tell me the what is current across R1, that's 2 ohm, and this. So again, directly you can using current divider rule. Current divider rule. What can you write? I1, that's I1 equals resistance of the other branch, that's 3, by total. Total is 3 plus 2, that's 5, and times 12 current coming, that's 6. So in this situation, what we get? 6 3 is 18, 18 divided by 5, 5 3 is 15, and 3.6 ampere. Okay, and so I2 you want to get? Then again I can use the simple trick, that's 12 current coming is 6, and in this branch, upper branch going 3.6, so 3.6 I have subtract, 6 minus 3 is 3, and still 0.4 going, 6 going, so I get 2.4 ampere. Or if you want to do the same trick, then you could use that there is current through the 3 ohm resistance. I have to take resistance 2 ohm. So 2 upon 3 plus 2, 5 times total current is 6, again 6 to the 12, 12 by 5, and so 5 to the 10, and then 20, 5 for the 20. So see, this you are getting the same answer. But you can use your own technique, whichever you like, this or this. You can use this. So this was the current division and voltage divider. Now let's do one numerical problem and to make this concept more clear. I am going to run. You can pause video to copy anytime. So not extension. Following circuit diagram, find, let me draw the figure and then I'll tell you what to draw. Suppose this is one of the resistor, this resistor, another resistor, and I am going here three resistor, and see how fast my trick works for you and how happy you will be after seeing this video. If you are enjoying them, I always request you all to share these videos to your friends and other people so that they will also get benefited from this type of the tutorial. I am making for this lockdown period, and later on when offline class I may not get the time. And so if you spread this, then so many people will be benefited. Okay, and see, I am taking the simplest case of this. Okay, I have taken the one single resistance 10 ohm, then 20 ohm resistance in parallel, and then 30 ohm resistance in parallel. And this is the 12 voltage is 30 volt. And you can do this question in a few seconds only if this question comes in your exam. What is the voltage across this? I told the V1 because I need to write V2 equals to what? And here is the voltage V3 equals to what? So V1, V2, V3 value you have to find. Next, I want to know the total current I. Okay. Then I want to know the total current through this I1, this I2. And here current I3, I4, I5. I need these values. If your question is this and comes in it. In trans examination, then don't go to solve these notes. All the values. It's a very simple way, and applying the trick you can find it. Okay, now let me use the second method, and what I am taking using the this current divider and voltage divider only, and it will be very helpful to you. Okay, now tell me what is the equivalent resistance. Let me write this A, B to make you understand only. I am writing other way, I could have already solved this. Okay, and so can you tell me the resistance from B to C is how much? Of course, you can tell two resistance 20 ohm is in parallel. Parallel, I told you, product by sum. I told you, product by sum. But I had also told you, if same resistance are in parallel and divide by number. So I am not going to calculate this. There is 20 ohm resistance. There are two resistance. So I divide by 2, I got the 10 ohm resistance. So is it trick? Do not do this calculus also. I told you, if all resistance are in same value, then just divide by number. 20 divided by, there are 2 20 ohm resistance, so 20 divided by 2 is 10 ohm. Are you getting? Okay, and likewise, if I have to find the RBC, C to D, RCD. RCD I have to get. Again you can do the, I told you technique, that's what your technique. So product by sum of product. Sum of products. I have told you. But here also you are not going those techniques. Just how many resistors are there? 1, 2, 3. What is value of which resistor? 30. Divide by 3. That's why I am getting the 10 ohm resistance. So I got RBC, I got RAB, RAB nothing to do, and that's a 10 ohm. Now tell me. I am going this resistance, this resistance, this resistance. Can I use voltage divisor? Yes, you can use the voltage divider rule. Tell me what is that? V1 equal to of its own resistance. V1 is resistance, here is 10. What is the total? This 10. 10 plus 10 plus 10. How much? Tell? 30 times total voltage. Total voltage is again 30, and so that's become the 10 volt. Okay, students. Now next V2. Again, it's very simple. If resistance are same, then voltage will be also same. So you can simply tell this is the 10 volt, and this also 10 volt, this also 10 volt. RAB, RBC and RCD all are same. So again, you may not use that that's a voltage division also. Just simply you can tell V1 equals to V3 all are 10 volt. If you have to take in entrance, but you want to show numerical calculation also, then you can use. What will you do? You are using again in V2 is this resistance system by 30 into 30 to just show you that you are writing more. Again a 10 by 30 into 30, that's a 10 volt. So one thing you keep in the mind, if resistance are same and current also same in series, then voltage will be also same. No need to calculate. Okay, so I choose this numerical problem to give you concept of the voltage divider. Okay, now let's see the current divider. Now I got the voltage and can I use current division rule? Yes, for that I need to find the total current. And so total current, if you want to get the total current, because in Poisson also we have to find total current. So total current equal to total voltage V and total resistance, these all are in, that's RAB plus RBC plus RCD, those all are in the series, so just simply sum. And so you know that, so this is the 30 volt and this is the 10 plus 10 plus 10 is 30, and so we got the 1 ampere current. So total current is 1 ampere. Now tell, if this 1 ampere current going from this, here I get 1 ampere, then can I get I1? Of course current divider will help you. And so current divider is I1 equals to, I have to choose the ratio of this, so this will be the 20 divided by 20 plus 20 is 40, and times total current is 1, so this 22 there, and so 1 by 5, 0.5 ampere. And simply I could tell if resistance are same, then currents divides equally. Again I could tell that if this is 1 ampere current, then this also 20, this also 20, so half will go from the upper part and half will go from the lower part. So I could directly write that I1 and I2 all are the equal to 0.5 ampere. Again you can use the voltage divider. Or you are familiar with the Ohm's law, then also you can, because you know the voltage now V2, and so I1 will be equals to V2 by ohm resistance 20 ohm, and so V1 was 10, that's divided by 20, it will be 0.5 ampere. So everything has simple, but what you need, you just need the concept which must be clear to you, when to use which formula and how to solve the numerical problems. This I would, I could use the current divider, even I could find by using the Ohm's law. Okay, and here I use just common sense, that's current is this, half is going up, then half should, where should go? It should go to the next branch, and so I use just simple common sense also. Okay, and so this also you could write 0, 40 and 1 is 0.5 ampere. Okay, and here if you have the Ohm's law again, that V2 is again 10 volt and resistance is 20, 0.5 ampere. So see friend, we found I1, I2, also by second its current divider and ensuing Ohm's law. Okay, and now what about the I3, I4 and I5? You can guess. Come on, tell fast. Waiting for you. Same trick. Up to here, this I1 is 1 ampere, this half going here, and the air also comes to only 1 ampere current. So here also 1 ampere, and 1 ampere is dividing equally in 3 branches. Tell me how much will be there? Oh no, you can tell. I3 will be equals to, one third of total current. One third of total current is also 1, so this will be equals to, what will be this? 1 upon 0.333 ampere. So I2 is also same, I3 also use, I4 also 1 by 3 into 1, that is 0.33 equal, and I5 also 1 by 3, that is the 0.33 ampere. And you can use your own favorite Ohm's law also, that's the use then voltage air is 10 by, that's 10 by 30, and that's 1 by 3, which is 0.33. I5, same trick, 10 by 30 times 1 by 3, that's 0.33. And I2, I3, I4, I5. And so, I3, I4, I5. Also the 1 by 3, that's 0.33. So students, tell me, is it clear to you?
Yes,
are you getting
sir.
This? Are you feeling this exciting?
Yes,
are
sir.
You feeling important for you? And you, when you will do the numerical problem of the voltage, gold and other pen, you will feel this powerful technique and tools using several times. So our question was, from the playing circuit diagram, find the values of, find the values of, I am writing as a V1, V2, V3, likewise V1, V2, V3, and I, total current I, I1, I2, I3, I4, and I5. And then you will start with the air writing this, and for you have to do the figure. And so go on doing up to here and then copying this. And so this question, why I choose, you know that. So I wanted to teach you the technique of the current divider and voltage divider. So I hope these things becomes clear to you and you enjoyed this. And this was a very important and interesting topic. And so next we have almost finished this DC circuit. And I think one topic is left, and that topic again we'll discuss in the next video. Thank you very much.